are servant of God.
Now we tell you,
and you are leading people. And a lot is happening in their lives. Sometimes they think you don't know. I want to take you or take your attention to the word of God now. In the book of Genesis, chapter
35,
God sent some words to his servant. Genesis chapter
35.
You read from verse 1.
Then God said to Jacob, "Arise, go up to Bethel and dwell there, and make an altar there to God."
Read it again.
Then God said to Jacob, "Arise, go up to Bethel and dwell there, and make an altar there to God, who appeared to you when you fled from the face of Esau, your brother."
One can ask a question. That all along, before God could speak to Jacob, which God was he still worshipping? Because God is reminding him of an experience that he encountered at a certain point when he was in trouble. God had to remind him. God says, arise. Get up. And go to Bethel. Arise. Go up to Bethel. Get up. And go to
Bethel.
And dwell there. You know, when you have encountered God, you don't need to be a prophet for you to talk about that experience. Because God cannot come and say, "Yes, but man." There are very few people who have that kind of experience. God will give you a feeling. God will give you an experience. By someone who is talking to you. Because Jacob, if you remember the story, he slept there and he had a dream. And that's how God talks to most of us. He speaks to us through dreams. After that experience, Jacob felt different. Jacob started to think different. Because of that dream, he said, there was a certain experience. So God comes to him.
He
says, "You, Jacob. You, Israel. Get up. Arise. And go to Bethel. And dwell there." Because where you are now,
it's
not the right place.
Jacob,
get up, go to Bethel, and when the church of Christ is taken up, and make there an altar to God, who appeared to you in a distinct manifestation when you fled from the presence of Esau, your brother. Go to verse 2.
How about verse 2?
And Jacob said to his household and to all who were with him, put away the foreign gods that are above you. Purify yourselves and change your habits.
Listen to the man of God. All along, maybe pretended as if he doesn't know.
So this cast, the other one was not
that these people have got foreign gods among them.
He pretended
as if he doesn't know. But immediately when God said, get up. They were not aware that the man of God was aware of all that.
In the way in which I have gone.
This is a man of God.
Let me tell you,
who doesn't hide anything.
Let me fix you.
You know, there was a, I think it was a week before last. Where I was talking about how I was rejected. So that people can know that for me to reach where I am today, I went through what they might be going through. Jacob is saying to them, at Bethel, I will build an altar. Because that is the place where God answers me during my time of distress.
Rather, do that before it's too late.
Man, she's away. late.
Staying at home and saying, hey, I will end up even drinking and end up even fornicating and doing other things, that will send you to hell.
Saying,
so that the King of Kings can walk over those things.
But the Bible in
verse 41
it says,
as he was approaching Jerusalem, he saw the unpreparedness. Pain to come into you now.
And the man
of God said, if you fall,
yes, when the power of God comes, I
wish you hit your head
on the floor. So that
when you don't fall, you hit your head on the floor. Because you forget quickly.
Let me tell you,
you see that scar.
So this scar now, what are they? Let it be. I'm
not going to Google. Who are they?
Ugo Boma.
Yeah. When you see that Ugo Boma, you will remember it. That's the day God touched me.
Without Ugo Boma,
so God can use pain
to remind
you.
Because
we are too forgetful
of
the experiences we have. I believe from the message we just received
right now,
so you will know the kind of gods that
I love.
I'm not about to say to you, no, I see you being one to pray. The things that have replaced God in your life, you know them. And you cannot go to Bethel. First thing, prepare yourself for where I'm about to go to Bethel. Prepare yourself for where I'm about to go to Bethel. In Bethel, they don't need those things that you're still carrying. Where the new altar is going to be erected, they don't require that character that you still have. Those things. You know that.